All right. Hi, thanks for joining me. I see the name, and because it's privacy issue, I'm not going to say it, but thanks for joining me today. It's Thursday afternoon, and this is a gentle chair flow. So again, I'm going to remind you that because it's a gentle practice, I'm going to constantly remind you about, you know, raising the arm, and if it feels like it's too much, just make sure you go at your own range. With the lunges, I'm going to make sure that, remind you again, keeping that 90 degree angle, knee and ankle aligned, just for the safety of it. If you feel that you can go any deeper in any of these poses, you're more than welcome to. But again, I'm always going for more of the caution side. Again, thanks for joining me. I'm Juliana, and let's get started. So we're going to move all the way to the back of the chair first. And again, you can have a block here, and this block can be really helpful to put between your legs when we practice, or under your feet. Again, instead of the block, you can use also a pillow, something, a blanket, even something just to make sure that your feet are grounded and leveled. Where we might use a strap just to hold the foot around, or it could be a towel, a belt, a scarf. And we usually massage our feet. So this is one of those massage balls, but you can use a pinky bouncy ball, you can use a tennis ball, something to massage your foot. All right, so we're gonna get started. And today the practice is gonna be more focusing of just being on the chair mostly of the time. So we're gonna just bring ourselves all the way back and just letting our hands rest onto the lap. And just starting to feel the connecting with the feet, the support of the chair, the support under your hands, so you can start to soften and let go. So if it's comfortable for you to close your eyes, allow your eyes to close. And then with your exhales, just starting to feel your body softening and releasing. There's a grounding through the feet. There's a grounding and rooting through the weight of your body. And just to help you to arrive to the here and now with a little bit more ease, we're going to do three cleansing breaths, inhaling through the nose and just sighing it out. I'm just starting to feel the tension and stress melting. With the exhale, just really letting go. Last one, even deeper. And a huge exhale. And just allowing your body to really soften and release. And just starting to notice the contact with the floor. You start to draw the awareness to the small little things that we can connect to the here and now. It helps to calm the mind. The grounding, the rooting through the feet with the earth. It's also a nice way to find a little bit more support. The earth brings a sense of well-being, of balance, of safety. So knowing that you are supported, you are in your safe place, so you can let go. The hips heavy in the chair. Again, the weight of the bones is another way to ground, to stay present. Feeling supported. And just feeling the hands supported so you can relax your shoulders. The shoulders drop. Let the tension in the neck and the shoulders ease. And you feel the back of the chair supporting you, lengthen the spine. And you feel this natural inhale lifting up. And a natural exhalation, softening, releasing of the spine, letting go. And as you start to notice your head resting over your heart and the heart resting over the hips, feels that it's easy to hold without too much effort. So you can continue to soften down and you start to relax the muscles in the face, the corners of your eyes. Unclenching the jaw, releasing through the back of the throat and the shoulders, down the arms, the elbows, and the fingertips. Noticing that spine supported once again and the belly's getting a little softer. The hips heavy into the chair. As you continue to release down your legs, the knees, all the way down to your toes. And as you find your body fully supported, relaxed, and safe, start to deepen the awareness to your breath. And starting to notice the inhaling expanding. And the exhale softening and releasing. Maybe taking your left hand to the belly and the right hand to your heart center. Just noticing the breath. The rising. And the fall of the breath. Maybe starting to draw a little bit more awareness to the belly. The lower ribs. That belly breath is really kind of comforting and soothing. Helps to calm. And starting to deepen your breath. Especially on your exhalation, which also helps to soften and release. As the breath moves in, noticing the pause and the breath moves out, long and deep, like waves on a shore, moving in. Moving out. Noticing that short pause in between your inhale. That little pause. And a very long exhale. Smooth as a thread. Noticing those breaths getting longer and deeper. And noticing now the mind calmer, quieter. So allowing yourself to come back to your breath awareness whenever you need to find quiet and peace. Your breath is always there for you. And just connecting back to it. When you feel there's too much going on, too much stress, anxiety, drama. Noticing that this peace is always there inside you and just using your breath to guide you there. And after your next exhale, just bringing your left hand on top of your right hand over your heart. And just starting to focus your breath a little bit more into your heart center. Behind the chest bone. As you create a little bit more energy and flow in there. This is a heart balancing mudra, connecting with the heart, balancing their emotions and your feelings. A self-healing mudra to help you to bring unconditional love and inner peace so you can find a little bit more quiet, rest and focus. This is also the area of your thymus gland, which is very important for your immune system, right behind that chest bone, the collarbone. And just taking a nice deeper breath into the sternum. And take one more full breath in, bringing all that positive energy, compassion, love, clarity, peace. And feeling that you can bring this peace to yourself and radiate to others, creating this ripple effect. And adding the gratitude of being here today, taking time to take care of yourself, showing up, even when things are hard. You come up and you confront it. You take your time. You do your best. And you get stronger every day. Bringing that light and gratitude into your practice of taking your time with kindness and compassion and no judgment. Treating yourself like you love, like you treat others, your loved ones. And with your next exhale, just bow your head to your heart, letting your intention and your gratitude settle in. We're going to release our hands down to our thighs. As you inhale, start to roll your shoulders up and back, and you're going to pick up your head. And when you open the gaze is to the floor slightly ahead of you. And then very gently start to lift up the gaze to eye level. And just feeling it spreading soft to the corners, edges of the room. And as you exhale, we're going to slowly start to move a little bit more. Sliding to the middle of the chair. And again, this is when you might use your block or your pillow, something just to put it between your inner legs. So you feel the inner leg squeezing, the core engaging, the spine lifting. So you're not slouching on your back. You feel a little bit more lift. We're going to inhale, roll the shoulders up. And as you exhale, down the back. Again, inhaling, lifting. Exhaling, rolling. And maybe start to take your fingertips to your shoulders and let the elbows reach up to the side and back. And just starting to get a little deeper. Exhale. So going at your own range of motion with your next exhale, you're going to release your arms down and you're going to just drop your chin into your chest. Inhale, roll your left ear to your left shoulder. Exhale, relax the right shoulder down. And with the next inhale, maybe just taking that arm slightly out. And as you exhale, bringing it down, maybe playing with the thumb, turning it back, and maybe even playing with the head, dropping the nose down, either shoulder or nose up. Just exploring it here and just feeling this really nice sensation in the right side of the neck and shoulder. With your next exhale, roll your chin into your chest, inhaling. Right ear to the right shoulder, the arm might start to reach a little bit higher. Again, as you exhale, dropping that arm, maybe playing with the thumb, the direction of the arm, maybe playing with the angle of the head, dropping it down, side or up. Again, the nose up gets more into the jaw in front of the neck, ear to shoulder more into the side, and nose down more into the back. With your next exhale, roll your chin back into your chest. Allow your arms to go up, lift up. Again, you're going to your own range of motion here. And maybe start like to feel like you're climbing up this invisible rope as you start to reach up. Again, if that feels too much to reach the arm up, you're staying a little bit lower, squeezing the block, keeping the hips facing forward. You're going to your own range and you start to reach and explore the side body. And with your next exhale, release your left hand down, take your right arm up and over and just start to feel the reach. Again, if this feels too much for your arm, you can bend the elbow or you can even rest that hand along the side. You're connecting with the side body. With your next exhale, release, inhale, both arms up and taking it to the other side. Inhale, feel the reach. Exhale, soften the head. Again, adjusting the arm any form or way that you need to get this opening through the side body without causing any more kind of pain to the shoulders or the neck. Inhale, allowing both arms to come up. As you exhale, we're going to twist. So again, just finding this middle twist. The hands can come closer to the thigh and to the side of the chair. You're going to lengthen from the crown of the head. And as you exhale, soften the belly and the shoulders and go a little deeper. You're trying to keep your nose more aligned with the center. You're squeezing the blocks so you're not twisting your hips. Inhale, lift a little bit more. Create space in your vertebra. And as you exhale, maybe soften the belly and the shoulders, you go a little deeper. And if you feel that you want to go further back, you can take that hand to the back of the chair. And again, one more inhale, lengthening. Exhale, softening the belly and the shoulders, you go deeper. And at this point, if you feel like you want to drop and look over beyond the back shoulder, you can. And then as you exhale, the head comes to the center. Inhale, allow both arms to come up to the sky. Exhale, take it into your cactus arms, elbows out wide. Inhale, open the heart, squeeze the elbows. Exhale, close. Stay into your cactus arms, inhale, open. Exhale, twist. We're facing the right side. Again, finding the hands on the thighs, on the side. Inhale, lift to the crown of the head. Get long. And as you exhale, soften the belly and the shoulders, you go a little deeper. So again, think about twisting more from the thoracic and cervical spine than from the lower back. You want to keep that lower back firm, facing forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. And taking maybe one more lift. Again, twists are really good for your digestion, constipation, your immune system. Taking maybe the back hand further back, circulation. And maybe exhale, you look over your shoulder on that last twist. Inhale, bring the head back to the center. Exhale, soften. Take both arms up to the sky. Inhale. Exhale, take it into your cactus. Open the heart. Next time you exhale, you bring your arms like parallel, like number 11s. Maybe staying here, keep the elbows lifted. Maybe you start to bring the arms closer together. Exhale, release your hands down to your thighs. Inhale, let the heart open forward and through. Let the chest lift. Exhale, start to round your spine like a Halloween cat. Navel pulls into the spine. You look between the legs. One more. Inhale. Feel your heart opening through. You can even start to slide your hands on your thighs. Your chest opens. Exhale, round your spine like a Halloween cat. You gaze between the legs. And just taking one more. Inhale. Feel that opening. And with your next exhale, you're going to start to circle it around. So starting to get more now into the side body. The head is very soft. And can you find a little bit more softness into your shoulders, into the jaw? And next time you're in the back, you're going to reverse the direction you're moving into. So start to take it the other way around. Noticing the sensation in the side body and noticing how you twist from one side to the other feels maybe slightly different. And then we're going to come back to the center. Inhale. Feel the chest lifting, roll those shoulders back. Maybe sliding your hands to slightly back in the back of your chair. Squeeze your elbows and feel a little bit more lift into your sternum, like there's a little string attached to it. Elbows squeezing, opening the heart. And relax, drop your chin into your chest. And as you inhale, maybe start to take your arms up to the sky. And as you exhale, bring your hands to your heart. I'm going to drop that block between our legs. I'm going to heel toe the feet a little further out. So the block can stay here. And we're just taking this a little bit in the seated sun salutation. So keeping your toes and knees in the same direction. Maybe start to take your arms up. You go into your own range, wherever your arms feels good to lift. As you exhale, we're going to fold. We're going to let the forearms come to the thighs. And from here, just relaxing the hands maybe on that block. Relax the head and soften. As you inhale, can you slide your hands back onto your thighs, feeling the spine opening? Again, you're always hinging from your hips. And as you exhale, let your elbows maybe come down. You can even let the hands support on the block. Relax the head. Find a little bit softness. So again, if feeling that rounding the spine bothers your back, keep the spine a little bit further up, especially if you have lower back issues. And as you inhale, you're going to take those arms up again. And exhale, hands to the heart. I'm going to create a little bit more of a flow. So we're going to cut that a little bit more. Inhaling, let the arms come up. And exhale, flow over. Let the forearm come to the thigh. It's a gentle fold. Again, you can stay higher if you need to. Relax your head. Inhale, slide your hands to your thighs. Pull those elbows back, chest open. Exhale, you can slide your hands back again to your shins or down to the block. Inhale, let the spine lift. Navel pulls into your spine to help you lift. And exhale, hands to the heart center. And just noticing maybe you start to feel that you're building a little bit more heat. Inhale, we're gonna take the arms up. And then from here, just taking a little bit of a lymphatic massage, take one hand and just moving it down the arms, down under the armpit, under the chest bone to the heart. And then taking the other, inhaling, exhaling, start to bring it down. Under. We're gonna do that just two more times, one at each side. Inhale, exhale, bring it down. Under the chest bone to the heart center of the other side. Sliding it down. So this helps with lymphatic drainage of the arms. Take the arms back up one last time, and as you exhale, you start to roll your wrists all the way down. And from down here, we're gonna relax our shoulders. So you do a lot of arms up just to help with that drainage, and the lymphatic system helps with your circulation. Roll the shoulders. And once again, just reminding yourself, grabbing that block, place it between your legs. We're gonna come into a massage of the hands. So we're gonna hold one hand, and we're gonna come onto the base and the palm. You're gonna start to press with your thumbs, and you're going up into the middle, and you're getting all these acupressure points onto your hands. This is a really good one for neuropathy on the hands, arthritis, and fingers, and just coming up. I'm gonna start to move it into each finger. And now that it's feeling really warm and heat, again, anytime that you feel that you need to take a break to get water, please do. Also, the heat might help with the joints and not being too achy. In the winter, it's usually worse. And we're gonna scrape the hands on the back. Just noticing, like you're putting a tight glove. You're coming from the base of the fingers down to the wrists. And getting through the wrists is really a nice way for that carpal tunnel repetitive movement. Getting into the side also from the thumb side to the pinky toe side, like really pulling it down, wiggling those fingers. Now we're gonna do this little pinch and hold between the web of the fingers. You're gonna pinch, hold, and release. Move it to the other one. Pinch, hold, and release. One more. Pinch, hold, and release. And then moving it all the way to the thumb. Pinch, hold, and release. Nice. Let your hands relax and just noticing how that hand that you just worked on feels really lighter than the other one, right? So if it's something simple that you can do, we're gonna just repeat the same thing on the other side. Whenever you feel like you're seated watching TV or there's not much that you're doing with your hands, if you wanna add a little massage for your hands, it's always a nice treat. You can add some cream to your hands too, so you can add a little bit more pamper way there to treat yourself. Moving through up to the fingers. And all the way up. Again, scraping to the back. Going through the wrist. Just noticing the sensations there. To the thumb side and the pinky. And if for any time that you're doing this, if you feel there's any part that's calling you, we're gonna do that pinching on the webs. Pinch, hold, and release. If there's anything that's calling your attention that you want to go back to it and repeat it or stay longer, please do. Pinch, hold, and release. A couple more. Pinch, hold, and release. And the last one, pinch, hold, and release. Nicely done. Give it a shake. Noticing how they should feel a little bit lighter and more even now. And I'm just gonna take that block out of the way so we can start to work a little bit more onto our legs. So having the hands close by, I'm just gonna bend and extend my left leg. I'm just starting to get a little warming up. I'm gonna point and flex my toes. One side and then the other. And then from here, I'm just going to start to open this leg a little bit more out to the side. So my foot is just going to hover. It's going to start to open and close. So now I'm starting to get into the hips. I'm going to open and close. So you can notice that my knee is just hovering. Actually, my foot is just hovering. My knee is almost at the same plane. And again, if you want to start to get a little bit more, you can circle that knee a little bit more. So this is going to definitely increase that range into the hips. So just making sure you're not doing too much and doing the other way around. If that feels too much lifting the knee, just keep that knee parallel. And I'm going to come back to the center. And from here, just finding a strap for your foot. Hook that foot over. Extend. So I'm coming closer to the edge of the chair. So I can dig the heel down. I'm pushing my hip back and I'm getting this really nice stretch in the back of my leg. Let your upper body fold over and just noticing the sensations. Relax the head. So on this pose, again, you're hinging from the hips. So if your lower back bothers you, you're going to stay a little bit higher. If it doesn't, you can soften your body over it, and that's going to take you deeper. Relax your shoulders, soften the jaw. And maybe with your next exhale, you're just going to hold onto that strap, maybe picking it up and even bending that knee up and over. And just noticing. If this feels too much on your hips or on your knees, you can always slide that foot a little forward. And if this is still bothering your knees and your hips, you can keep that leg down instead of bringing it up. So you're coming into a figure four stretch. And with that, you should look like a little figure four, a little triangle between your legs. You hold the right hand onto that ankle. The left hand comes to the middle of the left thigh. So again, try not to force into it, but just rest the hand. It's your upper body softening over the chin, the chest coming closer to your shin here. That's actually going to take you deeper into those glutes. The more that knee drops away from you, the more you're going to feel it as well. So again, backing off if you need to, if that feels too much. If you want to roll the ankle or pull onto your toes. There's so many things you can add here. If you want to add more, you can even do a little massage into your shin, moving it up and down into that middle line. And then slowly coming back, letting that leg come down and just giving a little tap. We're going to start to add the other side. So again, just bending and extending that leg. So the knee is not coming up high. It's just softening here. You can hold onto the chair. Point and flex the toes. Circle the ankle. Next time your knee comes bent. So again, keeping tall on the chair, engaging the core, start to open that knee out. In it. So you start to open into your inner leg. And notice you don't have to take that knee high. My foot is just kind of hovering, just sliding. And if you want to take more, you can definitely pick up that knee and do a little bit more of a circling. If that feels too much on your hip today, just go gentle. Just keep that knee the same height. If you circle one way, maybe you circle the other. Just noticing if that bothers your knee or your hips, you can stop. And then from here, we're just going to extend it forward. Finding a strap, you can hook it over a small towel or something just to have a little bit more sensation into your hamstrings, the back of your legs. You're going to drop your heel down, push your hips back. As you curl your toes up, you're going to start to feel the sensation on the back of your hamstrings, back of the knees. The more you curl your toes in, the deeper you're going to feel it. And again, try to soften the head, relax here. And it's the weight of your upper body going forward that's going to take you. So you don't have to pull too much on that strap. You can even be very loose or not even have the strap there. You can still feel that stretch. And with your next exhale, maybe picking up that leg, holding the hands. If you want to take one opening out to the side, you can, but when you cross it back, you're going to bring that ankle to the thigh. We're going to release here. And I'm just going to bring that ankle in. And again, maybe rolling, just exploring. If this again feels too much on your hips and your knees, just keep it down. Or even walk it down and just hinge from here, right? This could be a lot on the hips and on the knees, depending how you feel today. But again, just don't give up. If you feel that you need to change it, please do, right? So just feeling that chest lifted. And as you exhale, maybe you're folding. Again, if you want to pull onto your toes, if you want to massage into that shin. And as you exhale, you just let your upper body just fold over, relax the head, softening the jaw, and noticing how this gets a little deeper under your right glutes. With your next exhale, we're going to come up. We're going to release and just give it a shake. So as you find yourself back onto the center, we're just going to take the arms up one last time. And maybe from here, bending the right elbow behind the head as you hold. And then maybe starting to take just a gentle body stretch. If this feels too much, again, just be mindful. You don't want to go too much into it. Relax. And just bringing your right hand to your left shoulder. Look over the right, and as you exhale, extend that arm and look over the left. Take one more time in, inhale, let that arm reach up, lift up. Exhale, maybe giving yourself a tap in the back for being here today. And if you have the flexibility of grabbing that elbow, you can. Again, if this feels too much, you can just incline and go sideways. And as you exhale, slowly letting that hand come to your shoulder, look over the left. And as you exhale, look over the right, you extend your hands to the right, you look beyond your fingers, getting a stretch onto your deltoids and the top of the shoulders. Release your hands back in, roll the shoulders back. And we're gonna start to heel toe my feet here. I'm gonna come into a lunge. So again, making sure you have a block close by. I'm gonna turn my left knee, I'm gonna turn my right toes out, right knee and ankle on the floor. And I'm gonna take that block here and I'm gonna drop it under my left knee. So my right butt cheek is on the chair, my foot there is supported in a 90 degree angle. So there's almost no weight on my leg and no weight on that back knee, as I have that block there. And the block has three heights, so you can always change it. If you feel that you don't need the block and you want to go deeper, you take the block and bring it up to your chair. And from here, draw that tail in, pull the navel in, and you get this really nice stretch into your quad, your hip flexors. And you can stay here with that hand on the chair. If you want to add more, you inhale, you can take your left arm up. And as you exhale, you side bend. Now noticing again, if this feels too much, just drop that arm. With your next exhale, release, drop that heel back. And we're gonna start to come into a warrior one. You're gonna take your hand onto the chair and you push and you lift your hips. Now again, if you feel like you wanna sit onto the chair, you can, and you can always bend and soften that knee and just open your arms, all right? So again, you can take the pressure here as much as you need. If you wanna come up and use just the hands on the chair, just in case if you need to sit, it's right there. My left foot is in an angle, my right knee and my right toes are pointing straight forward. And you can always have that little bent into the 90 degree angle. Right hand is on the chair. And you can also take a block here and bring it under your hand to give you a little bit more lift if you need to. Inhale, taking maybe the left arm up. And as you exhale, I can open to the side. So from here, I'm gonna open into a warrior two. Left arm goes back. So now my chest and my hips are facing the long side of the mat. The chair is here and I have my hand on it. If I don't need the hand on the chair, I can take it out. And again, just be mindful, one side might feel different than the other. Feel the reach of the arms getting strong. Left hand can come to the hip and the right arm can turn up and you start to scoop it up. If you need to sit on the chair is right there for you. So maybe this is your reverse warrior, or maybe you start to extend it more. And even extending that front leg, you're coming into a reverse triangle. There's a little triangle between your legs. Again, if that arm's reaching up feels too much, you just drop the hand down to the chair. We're all gonna drop the hand to the chair as we come into a triangle pose. hand on the chair or on a block, wherever you need, and you start to hand your hips back. You start to open your chest more forward. So feel the line of energy on the side of the body. Hand is right under the shoulders on the chair. And if you feel that you want to take it into Uttita Trikonasana, extended triangle, you can take that arm up. But if it feels too much to reach up, just bring the hand to the hip and just feel that chest opening. With your next exhale, look down to the floor, bend into that knee, sit onto your chair, and take your time. Once you wipe your knees a little side to side, we're going to slide our left butt cheek to the chair. Again, adjusting that back knee. If you feel that you need more support under the knee, if the knee bothers you, again, having that knee supported and the front thigh in a 90 degree angle supported, I have no weight here. So it's easier to hold into it. If you want to make it harder, again, you can take that block and just bring it back up to your chair. So now there's a little bit more weight here, dropping into that tailbone, a little cat tilt, and you start to feel this opening into the quad. The hand can stay on the chair. And if you want to add more, you can take that right arm up and even turn it into a twisted lunge. As you exhale, release. And we're going to drop the back heel. So again, if you want to start to come up, your right foot is in an angle, your left knee and toes are pointing forward. Don't let that knee flop in. Keep it opening more to the pinky toe. If you need to sit on the chair, it's right there. Your hand can stand on the chair the entire time, just letting that right hand open back. If you have it into your warrior two, you extend the front arm forward. And from here, your choice, maybe you're taking your left arm up and you start to scoop. Right hand can come to the hip, reversing your warrior. And turning this into a reverse triangle by extending that front leg. So it starts to extend and maybe reaching back. And again, if this feels too much for your shoulders, you're going to always stay with the hands on the block, on the floor and the chair. From here, we're going to actually drop that hand down, coming into triangle. So hands on the chair or on your block. And you start to hinge your hips back and you start to feel your chest, the side body getting long. You can stay here and open your shoulders, or you can start to extend that arm up, finding your Uttita Trikonasana, extended triangle. Feel the inner legs pulling together. Feel that instead of pushing too much into that hand, the top hand pulls you up a little bit more if you're using that. And with your next exhale, soften into the knee. And slowly find your way back into your seat. Heel toe your feet closer in. Give it a little tap, a little roll into the shoulders. And we're gonna come up into our standing here. I'm just taking the blocks out of the way. And from this, I'm just gonna use the chair. So I'm gonna shift the weight slightly forward, pick up onto the chair and start to lift and come down. Now, if you want to feel like that, you can bring your hands to your shoulders. You can do that. One more. Hands on the chairs or on your shoulders, and we're going to come all the way up. Inhale, let your arms come up. And exhale, bring them down. Nice. I'm just going to move that chair a little bit more to the front so I have space here. And I'm going to massage my right foot. So taking your ball and taking it under the right foot. And you're gonna move it back and forth. Just feeling for the sensations in the feet. And then having the heel on the floor and letting the ball stay on the ball of the foot as you grip your toes. I'm just gonna move this camera, maybe give a little bit more focus on the feet. So again, these exercises are really good for neuropathy on the feet. Arthritis. And as you're closing and opening the toes, you start to roll from the pinky toe mound to the big toe mound. It's starting to get a little bit more opening there. And start to find a little bit more into the arch. And just noticing if there's any other spots that you might be missing. Any spots that calling a little bit more attention. And always having your hands supported, again, on the chair, on your wall, on your counter, so you don't lose your balance, just in case if you have the pins and needles or numbness of neuropathy. When I'm getting closer to my heel, I'm going to change so the ball of the foot becomes my anchor so I can climb up like a high heel shoe and move it around. And then when you come down, again, noticing the difference between one foot and the other, the dropping of the arch, the grounding of the leg, and we're going to repeat the same thing on the other side. So using that ball to massage up and down, keeping onto the ball of the foot closer to the toes, doing that little gripping, spreading, rolling from the big toe mound to the pinky toe mound. And again, you can always add more weight if you want to. It's very helpful to have the ball under like a mat under the ball or some surface that's not going to roll. So if you're doing it on a hardwood floor, it might feel like the ball will escape for you. You might have to chase your ball. But if you're into the mat, it's usually easier, or on a rug or a carpet. But to move it closer to the heel. When you start to do that, I'm going to let my ball, the foot, be my anchor so I can climb up a little bit higher. Just adding a little bit more pressure. Nice. And as you exhale, coming out of it. Beautiful. And just noticing how the feet should feel a little bit more even, more supported. So we're going to change this soon. Let me just take it back. All right. So from here, now that you have the massage under your feet, you're just gonna take it into a down dog or puppy on the chair. So you can have the hands on the chair, or you can even cross your forearms if extending your arms feels too much. And this is a really nice exercise. It stretches almost the entire body here. You soften into your knees and you let your head come almost like between your arms. If you have high blood pressure or glaucoma, you wanna keep your head a little bit more lifted. Otherwise, your chin drops. And then from here, you start to bend one knee a little bit more than the other. And your feet are hip-width distance apart, can be even a slightly wider. And you just start to soften. You can even start to look under one armpit and then the other. So you feel the tailbone going up and back, and you feel the stretch from the crown of the head, down the armpits, the side body, the spine, down your hamstrings, all the way to your heels. And with your next exhale, slowly round your spine very slow, so when you come up, you don't get dizzy. Take your time. And now with this really hot, you know, humid, just remind yourself to drink plenty of water so you don't get dizzy. We're going to take the block here, and I'm going to transfer it to the left side. To the outer side. Let's put it that way. So this leg that's closer to the chair is going to be your rooting leg. And I'm just going to slide my foot on top of that. And then I'm just going to turn my heel inside. So I'm starting to support there. This is a tree pose. I can take one hand to the heart. Now, if you feel that you need the chair, it's right there for you. Maybe I take a little bit more of a leap and take both hands. If you feel like you want to slide your foot higher up, that's how it makes it easier, having the block. If you don't have the block, again, you can always keep the toes on the floor, the toes on the block. And then maybe letting your branches grow. Just feeling a little bit more height, lift, reaching through the branches, reaching through the side body. You're bringing your arms as far as you're comfortable with. And as you exhale, you roll your wrists all the way down. And just as you drop that foot down, you slowly roll the shoulders and take it to the other side. I'm going to just move the chair to the other side so it makes it easier so I don't turn my back to you. And my inner leg is going to be my rooting leg. And then I'm going to take the other heel and push it into that inner leg, feeling that connection into the like inseam of the leg, feeling it bring it up from the feet, sole of the foot all the way up. And then maybe taking one hand to the heart. Connect with the breath. Maybe taking both. Now it's up to you. If you want to stay here and you want to explore going a little bit higher, you can. You can slide that foot a little bit higher if you want to. I'm thinking about like a strong tree rooting down, connecting with the earth, supporting you, navel pulling in, upper back lifting, branches growing strong. And with your next exhale, roll your wrists all the way down. Beautiful. And we're going to come down. We're going to close our practice. So take your time. Stepping back, finding your chair once again. And as you sit onto your chair, let your body settle in. And then once again, like we started, feeling for your feet grounding, your hands on your lap, and that sensation of the spine lengthening, head resting over the heart and heart resting over the hips. Everything stacked. You soften the corners of your eyes, let them close. And softening the cheeks and the jaw. You soften the base of your tongue. You might even feel it floating. Feeling the room and the mouth and the softness to the back of the throat. Allow your shoulders to release. Allow your elbows to soften all the way to your fingertips. As you notice your spine supported, you feel your heart light and the belly soft. And your hips heavy. You soften to the quads, the knees, ankles, and toes. If you're happy where you are, stay where you are. You can stay as long as you want. You're in the safety and comfort of your own home. If you feel ready to move, just start to deepen the breath. Take your time. Maybe wiggling the fingers and the toes. And letting your hands return back to your heart center, one over the other, over the heart. Connecting with your breath once again, just feeling the echo of your practice. Remembering the light and the gratitude you brought into your practice, and shining even brighter in your heart. As we carry it with you, bow your head to your heart. Surrendering the mind to the divine in the heart. Let your heart guide you. Namaste. Thank you so much for coming. I hope you guys have a great rest of the day. Again, if you have any questions, doubts, feedback, please let me know. And there's a few links there on the chat that if you feel that you need a little bit more support and help, especially in these times, there's a lot of grief and anger and sadness in the air. Feel free to contact us. You know, Dana-Farber's here for helping you to heal and to be safe and healthy. Again, be well, and I'll see you guys next week. Namaste.